Hello everyone, I welcome you all to B2R Design Academy. It's a one-stop destination for internships and job updates in various private and government organizations. Do watch the video till the end and don't forget to subscribe to the channel and like the video if you like it. In this video, we'll be discussing about the job opportunity provided by BARC, that is Baba Atomic Research Center. It is for graduates from both engineering as well as degree students. The last date for application is 11th Feb 2022. The website link will be provided in the description and the advertisement will also be provided in the description. You can check it out from there. In this video, I will give you a complete description about the eligibility criteria, what will be the pay scale, and what is the process for getting recruited in this organization. So let's continue with the video. As you can see over here, this is the official website for Baba Atomic Research Center online examinations. This link will be provided in the description. So now here, when you come to the home page, we can see few tabs are there where we can directly go in for the candidate login, or if you have already created your login ID, or else you can go with apply online. So for this, first we'll understand what are the programs that are being offered. So here there are two different programs through which you will be selected at the post of scientific officer, which is a group A post in the government of India. So the two programs are, one is 1 year orientation course for engineering graduates and science postgraduates. It is for the students from 2022 to 2023. And the next one is a course of 2 years for DAE graduate fellowship scheme for engineering graduates. So what is the difference between these two courses are, from the first course, that is OCES course, you will be provided a training of 1 year, after which you will be directly recruited in the organization as a scientific officer. After this, it's up to you to either pursue your master's in any institute of national repute. Right, it is not compulsory. But when coming over to 2 year DAE program, that is DGFS program, here it is compulsory for the students to secure a seat in MTech program in a good organizations like IITs, NITs, whose list is being provided in the advertisement. We can go through over there. So for these students, they have to first complete their masters. After completion of their masters, they will be absorbed in the institute, that is BARC. Till there, they will be provided stipend and scholarship for completing their postgraduate studies in the second program. And after this, they will be provided a bond of 3 years service after completion of training. The bond will be of rupees 7 lakhs about for OCES candidates, and it will be about 13,60,000 for DGFS, 13,58,000 to be exact. Right, so the stipend of about 55,000 will be provided for OCES students first phase, and for DGFS students they will be providing this complete semester's fees, and book allowance for also will be provided. Now after completion of their training period, what will be their pay scale is, it will be the level of 10 in the 7th CPC pay matrix. It will be ranging from 56,100 plus allowances. So completely they will be coming out to be around 1,05,000, including the allowances for rent, home allowances. So this, if the home allowances are removed, then it would be around 84,000, right? Here in this whole other advertisement, it is provided. It is 1,05,000 monthly allowances. Now next, moving forward, what is the selection process? So the selection process is in two phases. It is like the candidates can directly go from GATE examination from either from 2021 or 2022 scores, or else they can also write the exam online test, which is be conducted by BARC, to get admission into this organization, to get recruited in this organization. So here, After this, there will be interview. First round will be online test. After this, they will be going for the interview. So the candidates who are having GATE score, they can also write the examination which is being conducted by BARC. So it is always recommended by BARC to choose the option of considering both the scores, that is your GATE score and BARC online exam score. So that will help you out in getting shortlisted further, because if your GATE score is quite higher, then it will help you. Even if your GATE score is lower and you have scored good marks in your BARC examination, that will also be helpful for you. So better give a good shot at the GATE examination and also attempt fairly enough in the BARC exam. That will increase your chances of getting selected. After this, there will be an interview. After the selection of completion of interview, they will be releasing the final shortlisted candidates. Right. So online examination, I have told you, those details I will be sharing you. And another one is on the basis of GATE score. Right. So after this, selection will be on based on interview only. So what are the eligible branches and criteria are here? Just a second here. Here the eligible branches are, first is the mechanical branch, coming over is the chemical, next metallurgical branch, next electrical branch. We have electronics or circuit branches are there. Next, computer science, instrumentation, which is also called as EIE, also is called electronic and instrumentation engineering. We also have a post for civil engineering, nuclear engineering, faster reactor technology, and faster reactor technology in other domains. And we have quality assurance and quality control field. So these are the following domain students who can apply. And relative to those, few colleges or few universities will be having different nomenclature for the subject. Like it here it is mentioned as instrumentation. So many universities might not be having instrumentation. They might call it as instrumentation engineering or electronics and instrumentation engineering, something like this. So they are also eligible for this. Just they have to check that it's coming in the correct proper domain or not. Now after this, the other criteria which is to be worked on is the age limit. Here they have mentioned the following age limits which are to be exercised by the candidate before applying. So for general category, it's 26 years and the age should be considered as on August 1st, right? For OBC it's 29 and for SCST it is 31 years. So if you come under this and below this age limits and you are having good technical knowledge and you are interested to be in the domain of research, so it's a good opportunity that you can apply for it. And as you know, the application fee is also very less. It's just 500 rupees and you can complete the application. So this was from my end about the BARC, and other things are mentioned in the notification or advertisement. I will be uploading this as well in the description. You can check it out from there. So all the best for the students who will be applying for this, and do let me know if you have any queries in this. Thank you.